Well, it's the morning of day 16. Feeling better now. The weather's better. And I'm in the Cirque de Gavigny. Still a bit of cloud that hasn't cleared, but it should go later. It's amazing, the waterfalls. That one's La Grande Cascade, the biggest waterfall here. And the highest in Europe or something like that. And I'm climbing all the way up today, which is going to be mega steep. And I'm going to climb La Taille, which is a 3,000 meter peak at the top. Well, this is what the climb up is at the moment. It's basically climbing. On my way along to La Taille, I'm really hoping that I can actually see stuff from the top because there's still quite a bit of cloud about. There's meant to be, in a little while, a flat place that also has a stream. It's the end of day 16. This is where I'm camped. Got Mont Perdido up there. I'm not sure what that is, to be honest, but that looks cool. This was all glacier, actually, until kind of after the Victorian times. I saw like a series of pictures that shows the other glaciers have receded with global warming, I presume. And then this is why I left Gavigny to the south instead of the northeast, which is what the HRP would normally do. I've gone onto the Spanish side and that meant that I got to see Brush Roland today, which is that breach in the Cirque that surrounds the top of Gavigny, and I got to climb La Taille, and then I get to see this, the Odessa Canyon. But another day down, another day nearer to the Mediterranean. Must be well over a third of the way now, I guess. I've not really looked. It's fine in the day, but then when you put your tent up in the evening, sometimes you do feel a bit, I don't know, just a bit lonely. But that's just part and parcel of doing this. But yeah, it's tough going at times, but then other times it's amazing. I think it's gonna get a lot, mentally a lot easier once I've overcome this next stage. I think if I can do that, I'll feel confident I can cope with anything. I'm just taking it a day at a time, or a few days at a time. That's the thing, you can't just think one day ahead, because where you finish one day affects what you do the next day, what supplies you have, where you can next resupply. There's always this big knock-on effect, and then you've got the weather and other things, so it's, logistically it can be pretty challenging doing this, but I like the challenge. But yeah, tomorrow's going to be a big day. But for now, I'm just going to admire the Odessa Canyon until I collapse and sleep. I'm on the first of the two steep descents of today. I'm just following this river down, basically, into this deep valley.
and have to go all the way up again. And then all the way down, like down super steep into another valley, Pyrenees Valley. And depending on how I feel, probably go a bit further than there. Ready to arrive in Parsan tomorrow when the supermarket's open. It's Sunday today, so I'm going to assume it's not open. Yeah, it's really hot today already. See how it goes. Well, that climb is harder than I expected, but I'm up. And it is an amazing view down that valley. Really liking the scenery around here. God, I took this variant. Spain is good. So I'm gonna find somewhere nice to have a bit of a break, take my shoes off, eat a bit, get ready for this beastie descent. This is where it starts, about 2,450 meters, going down there, which is 1,200. I'm about an hour into the descent and this valley is sick. This is the Pyrenees Valley, or Pineta, I don't know how you pronounce it, but it looks so cool. Really, really nice views coming down. I came from up there. It is steep, and I think some people would feel a bit exposed because of the steepness, like they were going to fall off, but it's not actually anything that crazy so far. Well, I'm still descending into this valley. There are a few tricky rock climbing bits earlier, but it's mainly just long. Really, really long. Just getting bored of it now. Well, this is where I'm going to finish. Day 18, is it? I got down the valley. Chilled out Refuge Pyrenees, which is just over there, and that's actually where I'm sleeping tonight. Well, I'm a lot further up the climb up the valley now. I'm really enjoying the GR11 again today. Really nice, coming up through some woods, a rocky path. The way marking's not amazing, but it's still pretty consistent. Well, I'm finally leaving Parsan. I've been here for like 4.5 hours. Not much to it really. It was a nice hamlet, which is the old village, but all the shops are down by this main road, which I now have to walk along for 1.5k. Bought way loads of food. Well, this is my casa for tonight, and I'll give you a tour of the place. So in here we have a stove with some litter. Then we have a lovely wood-burning stove with a chimney up there. And then there's a window. Someone's left some wood, a stove. Well, I've not noticed that. What's that? Some kind of bag on the ceiling. It's quite rustic, quite earthly. And then we have the bedroom. Well, it's the morning of day 19. I thought yesterday was day 19. I've actually been asked to add it all up, and today's day 19. Who cares? Climbed up over a col there, going along here, dropped down, head to Refugio Viados. Well, so far today's walk has been very pleasant. Lots of wooded hills, oh, mountains, still mountains. Some easy paths. Quite rocky, but then loads of track like this as well. It's quite different to what the rest of this week is going to be like. Well, I've made it to the refuge. It's like the hottest part of the day now, so I think I'm going to chill here and then set off again late this afternoon.
Well, it's 4:30 and I've only just left the Ados refuge, and oh man, I'm going to have to leave the HRP and do the GR11 for the next 3 days, I think. Because the weather report is not good. It's going to be storms all afternoon tomorrow, and then it seems okay the next day, but then it's like 3 days of solid rain. I really wanted to do these difficult days, but oh man, there's just no point trying to do them if the weather's going to be gash. I'm not going to be able to climb Anito. I'm not going to be able to do the high passes safely at worst, or at least enjoyably, if I can't see anything because of the rain and cloud. Well, I'm still in a bad mood about having to take this easy variant, but there's no denying that this valley is very, very pretty. Check out this guy. Well, it's the morning of day 20. Just left the refuge dust offs up there, and you'd never guess it was going to be storms today, but that's what the weather's told me, so that's why I'm going this way. So this is where I'm camping tonight with Matt, just down on the shores of that lake. Our tents are just out of view down there. Anito is up there somewhere. So I would have climbed up from the other side, but now what we're doing is this ridge here in the middle. It starts up there, we're following, going up here to the right, and then we're going all along the right hand side of the ridge to the end. And that's Tempus Stordes, I think it's called, doesn't it? 3,200 metres. The views are amazing. And take a look over the other side, so you can see the river. It's a really awesome place to camp. Really nice views of that lake, the waterfalls, and then, oh yeah. Look at that. Really, really nice place. Really like the Spanish Pyrenees. Pass to do as soon as we get back on the GR straight after. What time is it? It's like five past eight in the morning, and me and Matt, we're on our way up Tempestadus.
It's gonna be awesome.
It's gonna be amazing. The views are wicked already. So we've come up from down the lake we were camped at. You can't really see it from here. And that's it, that little ridge with the sunlight on it, that's the peak, I think. So yeah, we're going over all these boulders and then up the ramp onto that crest. Oh, it's gonna be awesome. This is the summit of Tempestades. 3,280 metres, 90 metres, something like that. That's Anito over there, and then in front is a slightly lower peak that's got Anito in the name. This is the summit. Took about 2 hours to get up here. There's some glacier down there. Really nice cloudy bird. We came from down there. So after climbing Tempestades, which is over there just out of view, now going up to this col and then buying lunch on the other side at a refuge. Today has been a bouldery day. This is the last col of the day, right?
I hope so.
Yeah,
so we've climbed another col.
It's all downhill from here.
I just ate hot food at the refuge down there. It's like 20 to 6,
and we're going to go to a lake with a cabin and drink beer. It's been a very long day.
Too long.
Yeah, a little bit too long really. But it's halfway. What?
You shouldn't complain, you hit this peak.
Yeah, I'm not complaining, that peak was amazing. Up about 2,300 metres now, we climb that col. This lake is really nice. Then we just get to Refuge Rustanka and I'm camping a little bit after that in another lake. Should be about one day from Saladu then. Definitely one of the coolest looking refuges on this trip. It's quite posh, Rustanka. Walking along the dam to get there. Really nice lake, nice walk. Well, Rustanka's down there. Just went up a few hundred metres. Camping up somewhere near this lake. And I've got a beer, and so's Matt. He's still on his way up. This HRP's just turned into a high altitude pub crawl for me. I broke my tent yesterday. Picked up and started to blow my mat away. And I lunged for it and kicked. This and I snapped. I tore this clip off. That's it. I can fix it with paracord. It's haggard. It's been super windy. There's no cloud. And we're going up to Montarda up there from this col. That's Montarda, nearly there. And there's izzards running around in it. Oh, this is the summit of Montarda. It really didn't take long to get up there. Fuck. I think that over there could be an Ito, Pick Russell, and in between it's Tempestadis. That's where we went.
This is Refugee Colomer. Well, that is, one's an old one that's closed and one's a new one. We've not quite worked it out. But yeah, it didn't take too long to get it really. It's like, what time is it? It's half 12. After this, just got a long descent down a valley to Saladu. It's
been really bouldery the last few days, so got some aches and pains in my knee.
Well, that third stage of the walk, it's not really turned out how I planned it to. Still really disappointed that I missed the most tricky days, but I didn't know what the weather was going to do. I only had that report to go by, and it looked really bad. I've been on the GR11 for like a week now, I guess. I don't know, the days really do kind of merge into one. Feels good to be back on the HRP. And yeah, that stage was really cool because I ended up meeting two really nice people and walking with them for a good few days. And did Tempestadis with Matt, which I didn't even know about. That was a really cool peak to do.
Well, I'm at the bottom of the valley now. I go through this first village, Tredos, something, and then I get to Solidu about 15 minutes later. It's really hot now. Try and find somewhere to stay that's cheap tonight, and then I might get a bit more upmarket. There's a simple hotel. Get that tomorrow. Just need Wi-Fi and a shower.
Okay. I may have gone a bit overboard with my resupply for the next part of my hike. It's like, I'm gonna eat this ice cream in a minute. A lot of cake, cheese, some more cake. This stuff, which has even more fat than the Nutella. Couscous. I'm gonna eat the cereal in a minute. Oh my god, I've got milk. It's fuel for my stove. Porridge. Some more cheese. Gonna eat this jam today and tomorrow. Noodles. Soup for the couscous. It's got three of these things. Nuts are really expensive in the shop. Got a beer. Little bottles of olive oil. Oh, that's perfect. Oh, and I got a load of fruit. I'm eating all this fruit before I go. Well, I've picked a good day for a rest day. Good timing. Yeah, this is all meant to go by tomorrow. Just in time for me to set up. Just been doing absolutely nothing today, just relaxing and eating a lot. It's been good.
Solidu's actually a really nice place, got a really nice church. I like it.